Hey everybody, this is Aiden Lawrence, and I got something cool for you on my bench today. This is my latest and greatest Mega Blaster 2 Sega Genesis video game music player, and I've learned a lot since the original version, so let me go over some of the new features. So first off, one of the coolest features is the analog stage is totally redone. It's based on the Kunoichi analog stage, and another cool thing is you can actually swap between the YM2612 and YM3438 on the fly using these dip switches. And you can also mix the PSD volume if you want to do that. There's also a master volume knob for just the entire mix. We've upgraded to a drastically better Atmel ATSAMD 51 chip. And compared to the STM32 that I used in the last one, yeah, this thing is rocking when it comes to memory and clock speed, and basically absolutely every spec has been improved. There is a boost converter up here to manage USB power and send it through linear regulator, so it is nice and clean. The board is properly routed this time, no more OLED interference like the old Mega Blaster had, and it's so quiet noise-wise that you can actually hear the TinyDivision multiplexer on the YM2612, which is noise that you can't get rid of unless you switch to the YM3438. Anyway, I digress. So on the software side of things, there's actually been market improvements compared to the last version of the Mega Blaster. For one, the last version of the Mega Blaster actually had issues with playing VGMs at a consistent speed. This time, no more. The VGM engine has been written from scratch. Another cool feature is that it actually does VGZ decompression on the fly, so you can play uncompressed or compressed VGM files, no problem, without having to decompress them in advance, although it does speed up performance when you do that. If you notice right here, there's actually a dedicated 64 megabit SRAM chip, and that's super cool because it allows you to do really big PCM samples, and there is support for DAC streams, so super big, awesome PCM samples on homebrew tracks totally work on this new Mega Blaster. Going back to the hardware a little bit, I think I already mentioned it, but you can swap the YM2612 and YM3438 on the fly. There is a preamp section, a volume potentiometer, and actually a headphone driver, a properly properly spec'd one. The one on the Mega Blaster was a little bit too much. This one is a linear class AB amp, so it'll drive headphones just fine, and if you just lower the volume to line level, you can record off it, no problem. If you notice this flash chip right here, that's actually part of the bootloader, and what's cool is updating the firmware is just about as easy as dragging a file directly onto a flash drive. That is the UF2 bootloader, and that makes it so updating firmware is nice and easy. The printed circuit board is 4 later this time, and it's actually properly routed out, so the noise level is very, very low, especially when it comes to the routing of the OLED that has been star grounded basically directly to the USB port, so there's no more OLED interference, and yeah, it sounds super, super good. Another cool feature I'd like to point out is I've actually written a routine to verify YM2612 and YM3438s to check for dead chips or fake chips, just so you know right off the bat if you should unplug your unit and replace the chip. So this right here is a real YM2612, but something is busted internally, and when I power this up, it'll actually detect it within the first second and give you a warning. Hey, something's wrong, you should unplug your YM2612, it might be fake. So if you plan to build one of these yourself and you're not quite sure if you got a real chip or not, this will actually check it for you. Now jumping back into the software side of things, this actually has a graphical user interface. The last Mega Blaster actually was pretty much just you put files on the root of an SD card and that's it. You had some input, but you really couldn't scroll through things. So there's actually a full file browser in here. You actually pick any song you want right on the fly, so boop, just like that. I'm just going to reset the Mega Blaster so it's nice and quiet for us. Give it a second, it's going to index the files, just a short little bit, and there we go, back to the menu. And actually, you can change a whole bunch of different things, like you can play the play mode, so if you want to loop a track forever, if you want to just play the tracks in order as they are on the SD card. If you hit shuffle all, it'll index every single file on the SD card and just play through them randomly. And you can actually just shuffle single directories if you just want a smaller playlist. You can change the amount of loops that each song has. So once a song ends, you can have it loop X amount of times, and you can actually change that to whatever value you want. And actually, you can change the ability for the player to loop one-off tracks, so just like intro themes or sound effects or Sonic's Drowning theme. If you want those to loop, you can. Otherwise, they'll just play once and skip. This device supports both VGM and VGZ. It will do on-the-fly decompression of VGZ files. And what's even cooler is that it also supports DAC streams. So if I load up this file, it's actually going to start loading in the DAC stream information to the RAM chip right here. And this is a particularly big file, so just give it just a second. And this is all a native hardware. Now there's no intro here because it's a homebrew track, but yeah, this is all playing through the real hardware. Using DAC stream data from that RAM and playing it on the YM2612 correctly. Alright, I'm going to finish up this video with a few demos from the YM2612 version of this board. If you're interested in buying one, there's going to be a link in the description. I really appreciate your support, and rock on!
and evil will ruin its path. And death will come from the sky.
Spielberg, give me a call for set design. I'm really good at making sets that kind of look like I'm a Russian babushka trying to sell something on eBay, but yeah, hit me up.